RotoView is the original patented smart scroll technology for screen navigation by a single hand. This tutorial illustrates the RotoView protocol as implemented in our various RotoView apps for the iPhone. The RotoView protocol provides start and stop commands and features several operational modes of RotoView scrolling. RotoView has two main modes of operation, the RotoView navigation or scrolling mode and the fixed screen mode. When RotoView navigation is on, the view scrolls as you tilt the phone. The scroll controller is visible during RotoView navigation mode. You can easily tell which part of the contents view is currently shown. The fixed mode is when RotoView is not active. When RotoView navigation is on, the view is scrolling as you rotate the phone. During fixed mode, the view is not scrolling when you tilt the phone and the scroll controller is off. The start command activates the RotoView navigation mode. You can start by shaking the phone up and down. Stop RotoView by another shake. Notice that the view returns automatically to its location just prior to the end shake command. Shaking sideways will not activate the RotoView navigation mode, only up and down. You can start by tapping at the last location of the scroll controller. Stop the scrolling by tapping anywhere outside the scroll controller. If you do not remember where the scroll controller is, long press anywhere on the screen. This starts RotoView navigation and places the scroll controller at the touch location. Drag the scroll controller anywhere on the screen for your convenience. For example, here we place it near the thumb. See how convenient it is to start and stop. If you hold the phone with your right hand, you can place the scroll controller accordingly. You can also use the optional RotoView button to start or stop the scrolling mode. This button is not shown when you use the full screen mode. If you rotate the phone above vertical, a temporary gimbal lock condition automatically stops the scroll showing this marker. You can start with a shake, end with a tap, or combine any start and stop commands. RotoView works smoothly with touch commands. You can start dragging the screen even when RotoView navigation is on. This stops the smart scroll and enters into the suspend mode. The boundary of the scroll controller changes its color and the screen moves with your finger. When you lift your finger, RotoView returns to the fixed mode. You reach setting by tapping the More button on the album screen. Tap Shake Gestures. Here you can activate or disable the shake gestures. You can also modify the shake gesture sensitivity. Move the slider to the right to increase the sensitivity. You can do smaller shakes when sensitivity is increased. Now decrease the sensitivity by moving the slider to the left. You need to do stronger shakes to activate the command when sensitivity is reduced. You can use inactivity exit to automatically terminate the RotoView mode when the user stops rotating the device. Select inactivity from the setting list to reach the inactivity menu. Here you can set the inactivity period when inactivity is detected, and also set the inactivity rotation limit. When the inactivity rotation limit is set high, small rotations are regarded as inactivity, and RotoView navigation mode may stop. We recommend that you activate inactivity exit after you learn all the start-stop commands. This will avoid confusion when RotoView stops automatically without a shake or a tap. RotoView has two scrolling modes, dynamic scroll and proportional scroll. For higher magnification, the preferred scroll mode is the dynamic scroll, where the speed of scrolling changes dynamically. The dynamic scroll uses two new gestures. The throw gesture scrolls very rapidly, allowing you to throw the screen position over the image. After the throw gesture brings the screen to the target area, the glide gesture follows with fine scrolling. You can repeat the throw gesture by tapping the controller's map. During the glide gesture, you can drag the controller to change the scrolling speed. You can reset the baseline for tilt measurement by tapping the bottom of the controller. Scrolling stops until you tilt from the new baseline. You can select various throw glide response graphs. Here we select graph 3, which has a stronger throw intensity. See how the throw is stronger with graph 3. We can also select graph 7 without the throw gesture. RotoView navigation starts without a throw. You can extend the length of the throw by increasing the time mapping of the response graph. Notice that by setting the graph mapping to 10 seconds, the throw gesture is longer. When the magnification of the image is relatively small, RotoView selects the proportional scroll mode. The scrolling follows the device rotation proportionally. You can change the default ratio for the automatic selection of proportional scroll using the proportional scroll settings. Let us set the maximum rotation angle to 50 degrees. The maximum rotation angle dictates the angle you need to rotate the phone for the screen view to travel from edge to edge. With a setting of 50 degrees, it takes a larger rotation to scroll from side to side. We now set the maximum rotation angle to 15 degrees. With a setting of 15 degrees, it now takes a relatively small rotation to scroll from side to side. Sensor setting allows you to change the gyroscope and accelerometer frequencies. You can also experiment with rotational threshold angle. Using the RotoView development app, you can experiment with graph design and explore the recorded ballistics. You can design your own throw glide response graph. Experiment with your own designed graph or with any of the other included graphs. The ballistics page collects the sensor data and the screen movements of the most recent RotoView session. It is useful for developing better response graphs. With the ballistics data, you will gain a deeper understanding of the RotoView technology. Please visit our website for more detailed tutorials on using the RotoView protocol. In this tutorial, you have seen many aspects of the RotoView protocol and learned how to customize its operation. We are adding and changing features of the protocol as we continue to develop the RotoView technology. The RotoView protocol is perfect for web and map browsing, viewing PDF files, documents and images, and any other scrolling activities.